Alas, bell jar glued it to the top of her bus and forbidden her to leave her bell jar. But usually, she, for this tour, she comes out and actually sings that song with me. And so, but she's always over here. So then she disappears and now he's over here. So I'm like, totally. So anyway, I just wanted you to know that if there had been any way, she would have been here. And we miss her when she's not here. So anyway, this next song could have been written by Chrissy Hynde or Stevie Nicks or any other girl in a rock and roll band. When Lindsay and I first moved to Los Angeles from San Francisco, it was 1971. We got down there in my Toyota Corolla, which had no reverse. Right forward, but no reverse. And that little car, we called it in the pocket, for like in the pocket. So we were in the pocket when we were driving it. Totally stupid, but that's true. So anyway, the pocket was like our transportation mode of transportation. And then, so anyway, there came a time when we joined Fleetwood Mac, and after driving the Toyota for like 7 years, we started, first of all, getting paid for us a week, $200 a piece. This was $200 a piece, $400 bills a week. And you just signed for it. And then going into the fifth week, we started getting $800 in cash, $100 bills. Sign your name, SN. It was a lot of money. So, I mean, for people who had no money, it was such a lot of money. So we were just dancing in the streets. And the thing that I wrote this song about was something that really affected me about that time. We had to go and do some sort of a little press thing, and I got handed a first class ticket. Love that. And I've never flown first class ever in my life. So, and the even more crazy thing was the long, black, shiny limousine that drove up to pick me up. Now that was really something. So that really affected me because, I mean, in place of my little gray Toyota was this limousine. And I was like stunned and speechless and really appreciated how amazing that was. Until I realized that it seemed as if the black car came to pick me up more often and more often. And when it did pick me up to take me somewhere, it was usually to take me away, far, and with no plans of really ever coming back. So if I had a boyfriend, or didn't, either way, whoever I was saying goodbye, whether it was like to my dog, or a boyfriend, or somebody, it was like, I'm not just leaving, I'm gone. So that car started to become a symbol, sort of, it was kind of sad. And I started to miss my Toyota. It's a much more friendly car. So anyway, it was such a thing for me that I wrote the song about it, and it's called Belle Fleur.